Good morning. Welcome to Garden City's 2021 Veterans Day Ceremony, a day to honor American veterans for their patriotism, love of country, willingness to serve, and sacrifice for our country. Today, we say thank you. This morning, the colors will be posted by the Garden City High School Air Force Junior ROTC cadets. Audience, please stand for the national anthem, which will be sung by Garden City resident Jim Townsend, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance, led by 8th grade Garden City Middle School student Julie Galdez. And please remain standing for the invocation given by Pastor Andy Briggs. Cadets, post the colors.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watch were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Right face. Forward march.
We will now have the invocation by Pastor Andy Briggs from Fairhaven Baptist Church.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we pray that you'll have your hand of blessing on this Veterans Day celebration, because Christ gave himself to set us free. We understand that freedom is not free. It comes through sacrifice, motivated by love. We thank you for the men and women who have served and are serving this country. Thank you for supplying them with bravery, honor, and a willing heart to give of themselves to preserve the liberty we enjoy. Help us today to give them the honor they are due. May they experience our appreciation and gratitude. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. You may be seated. At this time, I would like to introduce and acknowledge our dignitaries here today. We have Wayne County Commissioner Glenn Anderson. We have City Manager Doc Dougherty. We have our Police Chief Tim Gibbons. We have school board members Darlene Jabanowski, Sarah Raffi. We also have Dr. Alex McNee, and we also have Dr. Shotka from Student Services. Over here, we have Councilmember Brian Earle, Councilmember Jaylee Lynch, Councilmember Pat Squires, Councilmember Mark Jacobs, and I'm proud to say I went to high school in this building, 74, 75, 76, and my school principal is here, and I told him he's sitting up here today, very proud of him. He's well known in Garden City, Mr. Mark Gutman. Stand up, Mr. Gutman. Did I leave anybody out? I got everybody. Okay. And we have one of our council members out ill, Kelly Kerwin, and our prayers go with her for a speedy recovery. Our guest speaker today is former Corporal Billy Smith from the United States Marine Corps. Mr. Smith joined the Marine Corps right out of high school and served from 1996 to 2000. His MOS was 4066 Computer Specialist. Mr. Smith was stationed at Camp Pendleton. He was honorably discharged in 2000 at the rank of E4. In 2004, he graduated from the Police Academy and worked for the Travis Bay Band of Odamwa Indian Tribal Police until May of 2008, when he was hired by the Garden City Police Department. Mr. Smith is currently a lieutenant in the Road Division at Garden City Police Department. Please give a warm welcome for our guest speaker this morning, former Corporal Billy Smith, United States Marine Corps.
Thank you, Mayor, for this honor. Thank you to the city council members that are here, honored guests. Thank you to the chief of police. Thank you to all the veterans and all the patriots that came today. You are all one of the many reasons I'm proud to be an American. I'd also like to say a late birthday to all my Marines out there. Hoorah! A little about myself. I grew up in northern Michigan, a small town of Rose City. It's only 1 square mile, but I'm always surprised to see how many people know about it. Shortly after graduating high school in 1996, like the mayor said, I joined the Marine Corps. I was the only member of my family to ever join the military. I knew from a young age, about 6 or 7, that I wanted to join the military. I knew I wanted to be a police officer. My parents always supported me in my calling, even though my mother wished that I picked a safer career. But my parents always did support me. I really do believe that joining the military, being a police officer, a firefighter, is a calling. It's a calling to serve our country and our community. Now at 18, I was maybe not the smartest, maybe a little naive. I chose the Marine Corps because I was told it was the hardest boot camp and the most demanding. But to be honest, the biggest reason I joined the Marine Corps is because the sword that they wear with their dress uniform. Like I said, I might have been a little naive at 18 years old. The funny story about that sword is, right out of boot camp, like many Marines, I got married, I had a family, and I wasn't even able to afford that sword until I got out of the Marine Corps. So, yeah. Now in the Marine Corps I went, I wanted to be in the infantry. I never gave it any thought to learning a trade while I was in, but while in boot camp, I took special testing due to scoring well into ASVAB, and they told me I was smarter than I realized. And as I was put in, which they put me in computers and communications. Now, without going into the Marine Corps, I would never realize my full potential. And this is something that I've heard from many veterans, that you know they just don't know what they want to do out of school. They have a calling to go into the Marine Corps. They learn a trade, and that kind of sets them up for life and to do well in life. I do believe that the military is one of the strongest supporting agents of a strong, of a strong middle class and the ability to achieve the American dream. I have always told young people to consider the military. It is a great education. I spent the next 4 years in the military and received an honorable discharge on 8/12/2000 at the rank of corporal. Most every Marine you meet is gonna know the exact day they got out of the Marine Corps. I'm pretty sure it's probably that way for all the branches. I then went to college and then the police academy. I worked 4 years as a police officer for tribal police in Petoskey and then joined the Garden City PD in 2008. I'm currently the lieutenant in charge of Midnight's Row Patrol. I would like to take a moment and add that Garden City is such a great community to be a police officer in. I am also the recruiter for the PD, and one of the main points I make at the academies as I go across the state is what a great community Garden City is and how they support their police department. And in this day and age, that is very important to us, and it means so much to us. And I would like to say thank you. I believe serving this country in the armed forces is one of the most important things a person can do. Not all veterans have seen war. I haven't. But all who have served in the military have expressed a willingness to fight if called to. All who have served believe it is important enough to endure long separation from their families, endure very harsh conditions, and ultimately be at risk of losing their lives. I would also like to thank the families of the veterans that miss time with their spouse, son or daughter, and very often father or mother. They have also sacrificed much. America would not be America without the sacrifice of our veterans. For all the veterans in this room, thank you. Our great way of life and our freedoms that we hold so dear are due to our veterans. I know everyone in this room realizes that, and that's why we're here today. In today's day and age, many young people look at professional athletes as heroes. To me, a hero is someone that puts their life on the line for another or for something greater than themselves. I would like to take a second to speak about a hero, Pat Tillman. For many of you that don't know or don't watch football, Pat was the 7th round draft pick in 1998 for the Arizona Cardinals. He was the starting safety and broke the franchise record for tackles in the year 2000. So he had a very successful career in the NFL, probably very lucrative, multi-million dollar contracts. The day after the attacks of September 11th, Pat told a reporter, and this is in quotations, "At times like this, you stop and think about just how good we have it, what kind of system we live in, and the freedoms we are allowed. A lot of my family has gone and fought in wars, and I really haven't done a darn thing." Pat announced to the Cardinals he had decided to place his NFL career on hold to enlist in the U.S. Army with his brother, Kevin. The decision shocked many and garnered national media attention despite his refusal to speak publicly about the choice. I don't know why that's so shocking. It shouldn't be. During Pearl Harbor, many professional baseball players enlisted. I don't feel that the media was shocked by that back then, but it was more of a sign of American patriotism, like Pat Tillman. Pat and Kevin joined the Army that July, committing to a 3-year term. They were assigned to the 2nd Battalion of the 75th Ranger Regiment. They served tours in Iraq during Operation Iraqi Freedom in 2003 and Afghanistan during Operation Enduring Freedom in 2004. On the evening of April 22, 2004, Pat's unit was ambushed as it traveled through the rugged canyon terrain of eastern Afghanistan. His heroic efforts to provide cover for fellow soldiers as they escaped from the canyon led to his untimely and tragic death. Pat Tillman is a hero because of actions as a soldier, not what he did on a football field. Fewer than 10% of Americans can claim the title veteran. I am very proud to be one of them, as I am sure you out there are as well. God bless you all for being here and being patriots. God bless our veterans and God bless America. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Smith. Most of you know each year at this time, Associate Pastor Dick Rich sings God Bless the USA. His wife is going to be having brain surgery. He couldn't be here today. So our prayers go out to him and his family and his wife. But we're still going to play the song God Bless the USA by Lee Greenwood. Please listen.
Children and my wife. Thank my lucky stars to be living here today. 'Cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American where at least I today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. And I'm proud to be an American where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Appreciate everybody being here today. A lot of hiccups, COVID, O'Leary's under construction. A lot of people may have went there today thinking this ceremony was over there where it usually is. But we're still going to recognize our veterans, whether we have 10 people here or 500. And I appreciate each and every one being here. So at this time, if you served in the United States Marine Corps, please stand and remain standing. If you served in the United States Navy, everybody still remain standing. Let's hold the applause till we do all of them. If you served in the United States Navy, please stand. United States Army, please stand. United States Coast Guard. United States Air Force. I'm one of them. I got some figures here. You want to know how many people served in our country? You guys can sit down. Thank you. Just to give you some numbers, to pause and sit quiet and reflect on the service of those Americans who stepped up to make the rest of us the kind of life that we have in freedom. During World War I, 4,734,991 served. During World War II, 16,112,566 served. During the Korean War, 5,720,000. During Vietnam, 8,744,000. During Operation Desert Shield, Desert Storm, 2,225,000. And currently today, we have 1,395,391 serving. That's a lot of veterans, and that's why we live in freedom for all those who've served, and that's why we recognize them today. I also want to find out who the oldest veteran is in attendance today and the youngest veteran. So I'm going to start with the oldest. If you're 85 years or older, please stand, veterans. Any veteran 85 or older? Really? We got a gift card to Tim Hortons for $25 for the oldest vet. That's Mr. Bill Brooks. I happen to know him, United States Marine Corps. Hoorah! She's bringing you your gift card. Thank you, Julie. Now let's find out who the youngest veteran is here. Do we have a veteran 30 years or younger? Stand up. Wow. 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 40. 41, 42, 43, raise your hand if I'm missing you, 44, 45, 46, 47, Officer Klein, I didn't see him. Officer Klein, how old are you? 38, wave your hand. Garden City Police Officer Klein, 38 years old, our youngest veteran here today. Also, the sixth graders are normally here, but they had a half a day of school. They have to have a full day to come here because it's a field trip. They got dismissed at 11-something, so they still made us thank you cards, and they're going to hand those out. You guys handing them out? So veterans, please stand. These thank yous were made by the sixth graders at Farmington Elementary. Please stand to get one, please. All veterans, please stand. If you guys want to hand them out. Thank you. Don't forget Officer Klein on that back wall up there. 38 years old, and we got some up here on stage. We got our guest speaker up here on the stage. We want to honor our vets. That's what today's all about. Thank you. Please be seated. We had a late addition come in. I want to recognize her, our Congresswoman Rashida Tlaib. Stand up. It's our Congresswoman. Thank you for being here. At this time, Larissa Dougherty is going to recite a poem about our American flag. Larissa, come on up.
I'm the flag of the United States of America. My name is Old Glory. I fly atop the world's tallest buildings. I stand watch in America's halls of justice. I fly majestically over great institutes of learning. I stand guard with the greatest military power in the world. Look up and see me. I stand for peace, honor, truth, and justice. I stand for freedom. I'm confident. I'm arrogant. I am proud. When I am flown with my fellow banners, my head is a little higher, my colors a little truer. I bow to no one. I am recognized all over the world. I am worshiped. I am saluted. I am respected. I am revered. I am loved, and I am feared. I have fought in every battle of every war for more than 200 years. Gettysburg, Shiloh, Appomattox, San Juan Hill, the trenches of France, the Argonne Forest, Anzio, Rome, the beaches of Normandy, the deserts of Africa, the cane fields of the Philippines, the rice paddies and jungles of Guam, Okinawa, Japan, Korea, Vietnam, and a score of places long forgotten by all but those who are with me. I was there. I led my soldiers. I followed them. I watched over them. They loved me. I was on a small hill in Iwo Jima. I was dirty, battle-worn, and tired. But my soldiers cheered me, and I was proud. I have been soiled, burned, torn, and trampled on the streets of countries I have helped set free. It does not hurt, for I am invincible. I have been soiled, burned, torn, and trampled on the streets of my country. And when it is by those whom I have served in battle, it hurts. But I shall overcome, for I am strong. I have slipped the surly bonds of earth and stand to watch over the uncharted new frontiers of space from my vantage point on the moon. I have been a silent witness to all of America's finest hours, but my finest hour comes when I am torn into strips to be used for bandages for my wounded comrades on the field of battle. When I fly at half mast to honor my soldiers, and when I lie in the trembling arms of a grieving mother at the grave of their fallen child, I am proud. My name is Old Glory. Dear God, long may I wave.
Thank you, Larissa. Well done. At this time, we'll have a patriotic medley performed by Garden City resident Jim Townsend. Thank you. Thank you, Jim. Well, I'd like to thank Garden City Public School Superintendent Derek Fisher for allowing us to use the Garden City Middle School for the ceremony today. Also, Garden City Middle School Principal Kim Linninger for her help as well. As you know, this program is put on by a lot of volunteers. I'd like to thank Colonel Gilmore and the Garden City High School ROTC cadets, Julie Galdez for leading us in the Pledge of Allegiance, Dan York, Christian Gibbons and their crew, Garden City TV, Pastor Briggs, singer and musician Jim Townsend, Larissa Doherty and that fantastic poem, thank you. Residents, middle school students, thank you for being here. It's fantastic that you guys came with us today to honor our veterans. I want to thank our guest speaker today, United States Marine Corps veteran Billy Smith. But most of all, we want to thank all the veterans for your sacrifice and answering the call to serve. We owe you the utmost gratitude, and it's because of you that we live in freedom today. Just thank everybody for being here. At this time, Jim Townsend is going to step up and lead everybody. Everybody sing along in God Bless America. And then the pastor will come up and give the benediction, and that will conclude our ceremony. Jim Townsend.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you. We sing so much better standing. You ready?
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam, God bless America, my home sweet home. God bless America, my home sweet home. Thank you so much.
We thank you, God, for America. You have blessed us with liberty and abundant opportunity. God, help us to continue on in freedom. May we live each day in this blessed country after the example of our veterans, with courage, honor, and a willingness to sacrifice. We pray for those serving in our military today. Protect them from harm. Strengthen them for their task. May we stand behind them with prayers and encouragement. We pray for those veterans who are still at war, fighting physical and psychological battles. Heal them, dear God. May the peace of Christ restore their souls. As we leave here, help us to be better Americans, to love God, to love this country, to love each other. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you. This concludes our ceremony. Thank you. If you see a veteran today, thank him for his service. Thank you.
There's a lot of men dead, so we can sleep in peace at night when we lay down.